Hello, I'm Mr. Harmandir, a retired lecturer in metallurgy, preaching Christianity and Sikhism. I'm a scientist. I haven't been to the university to study the dead letters of the holy books. So I go by the Holy Spirit, and which rests in your heart. This is the temple of God. God lives in your heart. If you praise Him in truth and in spirit. But if you are telling lies and other things, then Satan is in and God is out. So you can't love Mammon and God. If you love Mammon, you have to cheat people. Then Satan is here, God is out. If you don't cheat people, you are honest. Then God is in and Satan is out. So what comes out of your heart tells you whether you are of Satan or of God. Very simple. So Christianity is of heart and not of the book. So books are forbidden. So here is the two kingdoms, royal kingdom of, this is the kingdom of heaven and hell of the Rabbis, which is outside, and which is the royal kingdom of God, which is inside your heart, opposite. And the Jewish people, hypocrites, they wanted to incite Pilate that this man is proclaiming to be the king. So then Jesus Pilate asked Jesus, are you a king? Then Jesus asked him the question, is it coming from your own heart or somebody else tell you? Then he retorted, do you think I'm a Jew? That means it was the Jewish people who were inciting the Pilate so that he can kill him. So then Jesus then told them, if my kingdom was like yours outside, my soldiers would have come to fight against yours. But mine is inside, my own heart, which is not outside. So what applies to flesh? The opposite cry to spirit. Then Pilate understood it, the truth, and went outside to tell them he had done nothing wrong to deserve a death penalty. But they shouted more and more. Then the Pilate said, okay, you take him, your king, all right, and do whatever you like with him. So he washed his hand under sun, means in the presence of God, Elohim, Allah, Parbrahm. And then he delivered Jesus to them, dressed as their king, with the scepter and a crown of thorn, which is deserving for the royal king. So he handed them over. So what I mean to say is Jesus, our body is not concerned, our heart is concerned. What goes into the heart or comes out of the heart, that matters. In the body, and the rabbis, here they say rabbinic, they were very strict, you should not eat this one, that thing, and people were so much bound by them under law. Even if the house catches fire on Sabbath, they won't put it off without the permission of the rabbi. So stupid they were, so binding they were. So that's why Jesus set us free of that yoke of the rabbi. So indeed our heart is concerned and not our physical body. That's why Peter was told to eat everything. All is from God. So here it is. The Holy Gospel of our Supernatural Father, Elohim, Allah, Parbrahm, the same thing in different languages, delivered by the First Anointed Christ, which in Punjabi we call Satguru Jesus, of the highest living God, Elohim, Allah, Parbrahm, that dwells within His temple. This is the temple of God, created by the demiurge, potter. the Lord of the nature, Yahweh, Brahma, Khudah, etc. And it is called Harmandir, temple of God, or Emmanuel, God is with us, because God will live in his temple, not outside. According to St. Mark 7, verse 14 to 23. So, this is the temple of God. Jesus summoned the crowd again and said to them, "Hear me, all of you, and understand, nothing that enters one from outside can defile that person, but the things that come out from within are what defiled." That means comparing, you know, what to try to flesh. In flesh we eat like this from outside and goes into our stomach and comes out on the other end. Whereas the other one is what comes out of your mouth. That means that is your drinking the blood of Christ. So that defiles the person. You know, it should be a hypocrite, should then pronounce hypocrisy. And the people who are truthful, they will speak the gospel truth. The typical example of the hypocrisy is the Blair and Bush telling that Saddam Hussein has weapons of mass destruction. And there was a major general of army who was in Iraq after the destruction. And he came to deliver a sermon to us, reading Christian men's breakfast, and I was there. So when he described his experience of Iraq and other things, people asked him, "Did Saddam Hussein have weapons of mass destruction?" He said, "Not at all." So it was a blasphemy against Holy Spirit. So those Blair and Bush, president, you know, and prime minister, leading the the countries, they were blasphemers. But that means the country itself is of no good, but are blasphemers who elected them. So Church of England, for example, is headed by Queen, and Queen is head of Mammon. Whereas Jesus was penniless, Queen is Mammon. So that's why the soldiers who died in World War I and World War II, the students or the priest, doctor priest, hireling doctor priest of the Queen, working under her, because the bishop is appointed by her. So they proclaimed that they glorified God. Those who died, they glorify God. And ask them how they glorify God by killing and looting people, when agape is our base. Agape means undivine, unconditional divine love. So in everyone is the God, because soul comes from our supernatural Father. So in everyone is the soul of our supernatural Father. If we hurt him or if we kill him, then we are killing our supernatural Father, as in the unborn child abortions. Abortions are killing an innocent man of the same standard as Jesus. And this is not the country of Christianity. This is country of Mammon and Satan. So you have to be careful. So the path of Jesus is as sharp, narrow, as sharp as the edge of the sword. So you have to tread it carefully. Otherwise you fall down and you will miss the royal kingdom of God. So here is the royal kingdom of God. We beat it again. So this is John the Baptist holding scripture. Scripture was up to here, letters. Luke 16, verse 16, defined that he was the last prophet. So he the prophet Elijah, the cornerstone of the temple was lifted out, and that temple in which Judas carried through 30 shekels, that belonged to him, John the Baptist. And he's a potter. Some are animal parts, some are human parts, some are bird parts. The soul in them is from the our supernatural father. So, that's why the 30 shekels, the temple priest took it and bought a field called Potter's Field, because he was the potter. So he baptized Jewish men in water in the name of Abraham, and Jesus in the name of his heavenly father Yahweh. And those who came to him, they were of Holy Spirit, that they realized as they become Jew outwardly, they break their covenant with Abraham, who was of Semitic race, not a Jew. So they become super bastard by becoming Jew outwardly. So they came to him for repentance. This is the baptism of repentance. And after that, you know, they desire to be entering the royal kingdom of God, where your soul is concerned, not the physical body. So here the seed, tribal seed, it will be sown into the soil to destroy it and make the tribal identity implicit by creating a plant, like from a wheat plant, from a wheat seed will come a wheat plant. So the plant is to be, from the tribal seed, you have to try turn it into a plant. And that plant becomes twice born, and then you have, you know that we have one father and we are all his children, sons, and no daughter here. Because son represents father. So then you graft yourself to the true wine pride, you need to suck the daily living bread. So here your soul is concerned, not physical body. So neither male, not female, not Jew, not Gentile. Much more in my other videos, if you are interested. This is above celestial word of sadhus. No money is here involved. No money. This is the Sabbath. On Sabbath, the middle candle of the menorah. And these are the six candles here. So, these are pots created by Yahweh. In this, these pots, on this pot, it eats food. And some food are good, some are not good. So that's why the rabbi tell them which one to eat, which one not to eat. And this one is of Elohim, Allah, Parbrahm, where from our soul come. These are pots, and without soul, they are dead. So this makes us the living one. So this one is the Lord of the Lord Yahweh. So that's why Jesus said, I'm the Lord of the Sabbath. But in us, you know, of twice born, we have one Father. He is our anointed elder brother, our bridegroom. So we are his brethren, not, we are not disciples. The root of the word disciple is discipline. You discipline the natural boys by teaching them the moral of Moses. We are not natural, we are twice born. So, this is the 12 laborers of Jesus, have nothing to do with the 12 tribes. Seven were named in the name of John the Baptist for morality, and five in the name of Christ Jesus for spirituality. So much more I can tell, not many customers yet. So let's carry on now. Jesus summoned the crowd again and said to them, "Hear me, all of you, and understand, nothing that enters one from outside, the food we eat, can defile that person, but the things that come out from within, come out from within your own heart. When you speak, you are speaking your heart, you know. That is what defile. You can see the psychic, you know, like Tony Blair and Bush, how they spoke, you know, that Saddam Hussein has weapons of mass destruction, whereas he had none. So from the core of their heart, what came out was blasphemy, transgression against the Holy Spirit, which is not forgivable. That's why this coronavirus is taking revenge for killing innocent people like Christ Jesus. Much more in my other videos. If you are interested, we can talk. When he got home, away from the crowd, his brethren, workers, not the once born disciples of the rabbis, questioned him about the parable. He said to them, "Are even you likewise without understanding?" That means you even don't know. You are supposed to know these things because the gospel got written over your heart through logical reasoning. So then you can preach gospel with authority from your own heart. You don't need Bible. But over in the royal kingdom of God, our covenant is of Holy Spirit and not of the dead letters. That is Jewish level. So understand, do you not realize that everything that goes into a person from outside cannot defile his heart, since it enters not the heart, but the stomach, and passes out into the latrine. In tomorrow you go and you can't touch it, it is so smelly. So when you eat, it's nice, no smell, tasty. When it comes out, it's smelly, you don't like to touch it. So what applies to flesh, the opposite applies to spirit. So what we hear with these ears, sometimes we hear very bad things. We take it to our heart and turn it into good things. And then tell them, this thing is wrong, this thing is wrong. As I told the Church of England, headed by Queen, which is wrong, you know, because Church, in Jesus, we have one fold, one shepherd. It should be Church of God, headed by Christ Jesus, penniless Christ Jesus. Here you have the Church of England, headed by the rich Queen, Mammon. This is Church of Mammon. And when her soldiers died, and her priest, docile priest, hireling docile priest, slave, no freeman, they proclaimed that they glorified God. Whereas the Salvation Army people said, their people died serving king and country, not glorifying God. St. Paul's Cathedral, if you go, there are statues of Viceroy of India, Marshall, and South African Viceroy, all that they died and they glorified God. Our brother William Booth is not to be seen there because they are not compatible, sons of Satan and sons of God. So Salvation Army people, they are nearest to God, whereas Church of England people, they are nearest to Satan. So they are satanic people. That's why you have so much corruption going on in society. And these ombudsmen and head of this organization, they are crook, no justice. So let's carry on. Thus he declared all food clean. That means every food, that's what Peter was told, eat everything. And in the, under the rabbis, it was so much restriction. You can't eat this one in zakat, unless declare it kosher. Even wine, you know, or water is declared kosher or not. Even air, they would start proclaiming. But what comes out of a person's heart, that is what defiles. As the gospel rests in your heart through logical reasoning. You do the logical reasoning with your heart, not with your head. Into the head go the dead letters. It is your heart that analyzes it, and not in the holy books. So gospel rests in your heart and not in the holy books, which are dead letters. So that's why our covenant with Jesus of Holy Spirit and not of the books. The law and prophets were till John the Baptist. Luke 16 verse 16. So holy books end up to John the Baptist, no more required, because they are corrupted, full of holes. From within people, from their hearts, come evil thoughts. That is what defile a heart, you know. These are the things that defile. Unchastity, theft, as Judas Iscariot was stealing money from the church first, holding it. Seeing the dog hollow priest, they are Judas Iscariot in sheep's clothing. They are thief. So you can see, you are employing thief in a church. And what he will tell you? To steal money, not to worship God. Theft, murder, adultery. That's why you can see church priests are adulterers. They are caught in so many adultery. And Pope and other people are there. But these Pope and other people, they are all antichrist. Because nobody stands between man and God. Everyone has to give his own account to God. So greed, malice, deceit, licentiousness, envy, blasphemy, as Tony Blair and Bush spoke, blasphemy, that Saddam Hussein is a weapon of mass destruction and destroy the country Iraq, which is the homeland of Abram, a nobleman. So this was the work of the saltless Jewish people in America who are Mormon and media, occupying Mormon and media. So America is the Jewish colony, is the colony of Israel. Arrogance, folly, all these evils come from within and they defile you. They defile the heart, where the gospel rests. And if it already defiled your heart, it defiled, gospel cannot rest. So you have to clean your heart so that the gospel can rest over there and not be disturbed by these things. So our Father God blesses everyone in agape, unconditional divine love of our supernatural Father Elohim, Allah, Parbrahm. So it's same thing, you know. One God, if you have one God, there should be one faith. No interfaith. Interfaith tells you that people are spiritually blind. So people who are spiritually alive, they know that there is one God. And how could there be interfaith? There will be one faith. That's why the book that I have written is One God, One God, One Faith, not two faiths. So I'm revising this one. If somebody interested, he can help me.